What?
That's when something happened.
Hey, Megan. How you doing? Perfect. Guys, we're gonna have coloring. What else?
Create your own
puzzle class, okay? And this is Megan. She's gonna teach us how to do drawing. Megan is a very famous painter. She paints and she makes a very beautiful sculptures. Okay?
We'll do painting and we'll do the drawing and we'll do the sculptures.
Okay, so you're going to do that now?
No, your time is now.
Me?
Yeah, right now, dance. We're going to do dance. Once I get tired from dancing, we're going to do something else.
They say the time's supposed to heal ya, but I ain't done much for me. Hello?
You got to dance, ballet.
Can you hear me? I'm in California dreaming of that
movie.
Is he recording? You don't have a lens on this. Are you recording without a have you find
on?
Okay, how many tables we need?
How many kids here? There's five. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 kids.
Megan, do we need paper?
I have paper here of everything. I just need water.
You need water?
Yeah, I'm gonna fill up the cups if we can wash the brushes off.
Be careful with water because it's clear. Okay, tall kids gonna hear Megan. Can you hear what she controls the kids? Do you want to put a mic on her? Or
well,
you can hear?
We can hear, yeah.
Megan, can you speak up so he can pick you on the camera?
I have extra these. I can give you guys some of these to take home if you want.
I'm trying to get it all
ready for me to go. Just to wash the paint brushes all day.
I like it. No, I'm gonna sit next to you, can I? Oh, here? Okay, I'm gonna sit here. Okay. I'm Barbara.
Want me to give you a puzzle as well?
Oh, yeah, I just need water.
Yep, I'm good for the lady.
Where can I get water just to put
these
in for the play?
Absolutely.
There's two cups there.
Two cups, water.
Okay, and then paper towel, because it's gonna mess.
Мама, я на секунду.
А ты куда?
Давай дам.
Уже ты, папа пожалуйста, мальчик. Надо быстрее. Ты говори. Папа
будет бежать.
Надо за папой бежать.
Я сейчас поменяю.
Okay, guys, let's look at Megan, what she's doing, and we can follow her.
Tell me when to start. Is the film?
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hello everyone, this is Megan Meehan here with Alexander Gurman Productions, and today we are doing an art class where we're taking these little cardboard puzzles, and as you can see, they're blank, and once they're finished, then we can separate them, we can put them back together. But basically, you can take these and design them any way that you want. So here we have paint, we have markers, and then we have clay. So ideally, what we're going to do is paint the puzzles first, and then once they're done being painted, we can use the clay to add some 3D elements to them and glue them on, and then you have a 3D puzzle that you can play with constantly. So, as you can see here, we've got purple, pink, yellow, all these beautiful colors. And you can make this any way that you want. These are mostly Crayola materials. They are very, very fast to dry, and the color goes on really good. The different types of brushes that you use make a difference as well. Like for example, when I'm using this brush, I get different patterns like that. Whereas if you use a sponge, the color goes on a lot smoother and a lot clearer. Or not clear, a lot smoother and a lot more covered, basically. I am going to make the green. See, this is how you make the pattern, so I'm going to probably make this into a little garden.
So beautiful.
And you can actually mix colors together too. If you put them on the brush and put another color on the brush and mix it. Oh yeah, and then we need paper towels.
Yes.
Oh, here's water so you can clear it off.
Paper towels. Okay. Сейчас, вот это дам, я поэтому тебе готовлю. Положи сюда, если ты желтый.
Это желтое.
Вот сюда положи. Это зеленый. А, это для зеленого.
Он уже красный.
Я сначала зеленый сюда махну.
Another thing you guys can do if you want is that you can take a piece of cardboard paper like this and you can take two colors. So for example, let's say you wanted to use the pink and the purple, right, and you wanted to mix them. So what you can do is you can take the lighter color first, like put the pink on here, and then take the brush with the purple, dip some purple into this, and then, or she can take two different brushes.
Oh, there we go.
And then mix the colors together. So you have the, see the way the two colors are loaded onto the brush? And that's how you mix and blend colors. And you can use two brushes at a time to mix and blend the colors. And it just creates a really nice effect.
This is sponge.
Yes, this is a sponge right here. The sponge actually goes on.
You may be the man.
You see the difference in texture? So when the sponge, when you put the sponge on things, it makes the color go on really clear. See that? The sponge is actually one of the best things you can use. So you picked a good...
This is how it'll be rolled.
So as you can see, the difference in texture. So with the brush, you can make textures like this. With the sponge, you can just lay the color on like this. And then here we've mixed some colors. We've mixed pink and purple to make this fuchsia effect. And like, you can just paint these like regular canvases. Lay color on.
Andrew, I think if you put the camera over the shoulder of Megan, you get a better sound from her, and you're going to get the... more of her drawing because she's bigger than this.
And you can also use the sponge effect to blend colors. See the way that goes? Now, ideally, the way to do this would be to like start with something. Like with this, I just wanted to show how you can lay it on thicker. But generally, what you would do is that you would start by laying it on like this. And then when it dries, I would go over it again. So that way the colors come on a lot stronger than what they look like now. Because these are washable paints, because I'm working with children here.
See, if you need her brain, she can take care of what you want.
See how I did that? I'm just trying. So basically, if you want to get an effect like this, the best thing to do is to lay on color. Like for example, I'm going to lay on green here, really thick with this brush.
Can you repeat on camera?
Sure. So the green is being laid on really, really thick.
If you know me.
Okay.
And then I'm going to wash off my brush, and I'm going to get the yellow. But lay on the yellow, thick like this. Really, really, really thick. See the way that's laid on thick? And then you take the sponge, the sponge is washed. Then you take the sponge, give it off, and then using the sponge, you swipe up, and that's how you get that effect. So if you want that effect with colors, the best thing to do is use the sponge. Okay? Yes, of course. The other thing about the glitter is not quite as thick as some of the other paints. So another thing you can do is lay down a color, like you see the way you have the blue on the other side, and then put the glitter on top of the blue, and that way it just pops a little bit more. Now when that is drying, you can see it's starting to dry already. Do you want to put in some of the clay? So what color do you like? What colors?
Green.
Green, and what other color? Blue. Okay. So what we can do is pick out the green and the blue. This is embarrassing. something on camera, I can't open them. Why? Okay, so here we go. So we're going to take out the green. I'm going to show you one of the cool things about clay. There's two ways to play with this. You can mold this and play with it, each color separately. Or what you can do is combine colors.
I like painting.
And the other thing that you can do... And then what you can also do with clay, see the way they are playing with the clay, the two separate colors? The other thing you can do with the clay, you can take the clay and you can blend the colors. So you mix them like that, and mix them in your hand, and the colors kind of blend together. And then you can create shapes with blended colors. And then you can actually put them on top of this. So if you make a little sculptural shape, you can then add it on top of the puzzle when it's dry.
How can you upgrade this to blue?
See? And there's the effect of the blended clay. If you blend it too much, it gets a little muddy. But if you blend it just right, you get a nice mixture of colors. I just want to show you guys another thing about the sponge that I think is really cool. So you can take colors that don't actually mix together. So you see you have the green and the yellow here, and then you got the pink and the purple. If you take the sponge, and even if the sponge is a little bit wet, it's totally fine. Take the sponge in, and you can blend these colors with the sponge.
It's muddy.
You see the rain? And this was a little dry already. But this is just a good base. So basically what I'm going to do is probably build on this base and create something really abstract and different. Okay. Do you want another piece?
Yellow.
We can put this aside to dry. So, I could put this over here for now. But another thing about this that's really cool is that, like, for example, let's say that you were going to sculpt something. If you sculpt something small enough, the sculpture can stay on the puzzle piece. And then you can later paint the puzzle around the pieces. And then, or basically take the pieces off and just intend to put them back on. But paint the sculpture, and then we can go ahead and glue the clay pieces on, and then you have a three-dimensional sculpture. So then this one's drying, so what you can do is practice on this one. So make the sculpture on this one, but plan to put it on this one. Essentially, that's it. So like, pick the piece that's drying here, and then just shape it up, and use this as kind of a map.
This water
changing. Any better? No, they're both getting dirty. That's the thing about painting. You have to eventually clear the water quite a bit. Where's the paper towel? Do you need the paper towel?
Yes.
Thank you.
Smiley.
So cute.
Beautiful.
I'm gonna go wash my
hands. You can even create whole play sets with this. Like, you can essentially make little, like for example, I could turn this into a garden play set, and then create little characters to live on the puzzle. Kind of like a play set. Little flowers, and then in all different shapes and colors. Like, this is the most basic model, obviously. And then when I'm going to let this dry, and then I will later on paint the background and then glue them all back on until I have a three-dimensional puzzle.
Oh, look at this one. All the patterns and the glitter. Like to do another one?
Yeah. Thank you.
You can't glue anything right now. It's gotta dry. You gotta wait for it to dry. So you see the way that you cut out the bone with the stencil? You just gotta put the bone to the side and you gotta let it dry. That clay, if you leave that clay out for about 24 hours, it will dry completely. So then you're gonna take these home and then tomorrow you can glue it. And the same thing, like I love the way that you use the glitter. You see the way that that he employs the glitter here? So see how thick that glitter is put on? It's almost three-dimensional. That's going, when that dries, it will go a little bit flatter, but it will still be three-dimensional off the puzzle piece, which is great. So when this dries, then he'll be able to add the bone and the man.
Смотри, как очень бедный.
Oh, what? Beautiful.
Можно разграфировать?
Конечно.
Мам, только сначала я маме покажу.
Конечно.
Мам, смотри, как очень горит. Графируй его.
Sometimes what you can do is you take it like this and you twist like that, and then you mold back in, and then you... I love these.
Like,
like I even use this with polymer clay in the art that I put in galleries, and I just love the effect of that. Like you can even make like a whole 3D painting out of
Papa, чтобы ты видел лицо его.
Очень красивое лицо у него. Make that beautiful face for him. See, on that side.
Возьми его в ручку, если у тебя с ним все хорошо. Или рядышком. А ты рядышком туда. Преклонись к нему, как ты все время делаешь.
Я ещё что-то хочу.
Like if you mix it just a little bit, you get a blend of two beautiful colors. But if you mix it a lot, like you mix the pink and the purple a lot, you actually get a lilac color. You get a new color that looks really beautiful as well. So even though it's a solid color, it's still equally very beautiful. It's got little textures in it. So you're going to use this?
This looks like a cotton candy.
It is kind of a cotton candy. It's like a pink coral, which a lot of cotton candy is.
Let me show you.
Pink.
I wish it smelled like cotton candy.
Mm, that's true. Cotton candy smells like cotton candy, but this doesn't smell bad. Play-Doh and Crayola products are really top-notch.
I buy a lot of clay, but it dries out.
Well, that's why I like the fact that it dries out quick when you're doing projects like this, because it makes it easier. You don't have to wait that long to connect everything. The one thing about the puzzle pieces, like if you're really planning out a puzzle, you can go either way. You can basically paint the background first and then decide what pieces to build onto it. Or you can build the pieces first and then decide how to make the background match the pieces. So essentially, there's no wrong way to do it.
I'm about to glue only these.
Is there a particular traits that kids can learn? Take home something they did not know until yesterday, and now they know today.
Definitely, a lot of kids, like, the funny thing is that properties like mixing colors to the point that they're blended, you know, blending colors, like let's say the process of doing things like blending colors, so mixing them just enough so that the two colors are distinctively still there, but not mold into one color. That's something a lot of kids can take home and learn from this.
Pink.
And the other thing is that you can actually put the glitter on top of the clay, And if you want the, you can put glitter on top of the clay. And let's say that you want the clay to be a different color, or maybe you want to add a little bit of color. When the clay is dry, you can actually paint on top of the clay as well, if you want to.
Can we make your child follow your instructions so they can kind of graduate? Can you guys?
This is her hand concealer by the Urmore Cosmetics.
It's tight, right?
Sprinkle.
You can dance a little bit. That's what I'm telling you.
Oh, yeah.
You guys need this and all. Then we're talking there before the sun is done. That's what you
might need.
I'm just going to blend this out a little bit.
I just want
to
make sure that we... Papa,
sprinkle.
Oh, you made a puzzle? Hey, you're the man.
Hey, come down.
What you did? You got it?
No, it's not gonna thing. I think it's good.
Yeah, yeah, you brushing now.
Okay, but Bob, I'll take that on. Do not take 2 seconds on that.
I'll keep it on that. Just unlock it. Cause I can't go in there. I got this computer.
Alexander has to do that for you.
Yeah, you'll take your one.
I'm going to salvage a bunch of display as I can.
Oh, so everything is connected. You just have to send the signal now.
So are you
the youngest? Now you can come over to both sides, right?
I'm an only child, but it's good to be, I think, youngest and only children are the, probably the best position to be in.
Damn!
And everyone is after you. My mom is the youngest.
You got that mixed in my eye.
Do you like this?
I'm going to teach you everything you know. You need to know, all right?
As long
as you got it there. This is the main part.
Now, I love the pink and the purple.
The inbox, I can put it just in the inbox.
We have
a
butterfly here.
So
we have a heart.
Go, you go there.
It's supposed to be like the sun.
Now I'm going to contour her nose. This is an NYX.
Yeah.
Contour, I can feel about it.
Our teacher name was the dog, the art. He told us to make different kinds of stuff. Oh, yeah, and we made
but you can't.
Yeah.
No, you can't record the whole thing. Just some of this.
Some of it.
Don't worry about that. Right. Here, you hold this one.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that
one.
So on the pan, I'm going to have it only for 2 hours, 3.5 hours. I'm not going to have it for that long.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to bring none of this. I'm going to just do it with, you know, with the kids and stuff.
Okay, on the
Saturday.
Town.
Yeah,
okay.
On Saturday.
Great. Mm-hmm. How long is it booked for today?
Till 6.
Till 6?
Till 7.
Mm-hmm.
I think we're going to get some nice good footage.
When we go down now,
Vanessa Moore's Illuminating Bronzer.
And
this is just to add a little pop to her highlighted services that I use the Bare Mill concealer on.
So right now I'm going to be making one device at a
time.
Okay.
Now I'm about to add Vera Moore
This brand new?
Yeah.
8th Avenue blush. I love this blush. Like, it's sort of like a golden bronzer type of highlight when you add it. Why are you recording?
No, he said record every if you do a new step.
But did I tell you I was doing something? So don't record.
Oh yeah, we learned.
Your supplies have been depleted. they've been decimated. As long as they enjoy themselves.
We know what we say.
I know it's so pretty. Grandma eyeshadow.
I think maybe you can curate an exhibition of
these
cards.
I'm about to take this apart and do it again.
Yeah, that would be a lot of fun.
I'm about to take this apart and do it again.
I'm trying to come to the same thing.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you're right. It is dry. So what, you can take it apart and then you could get, oh, you can add more colors. Do whatever you want.
Those are the ones that we saw.
Okay, let's
see now.
I'm going to bring my gel exactly for children and show you it.
I've been working on it.
What are you using?
I'm using her shadow.
Oh, you done said that before?
No, you gotta stop filming me.
I told you to tell me when you go to the next one, baby. You going too fast.
Okay, so with this, I use Vera Moore Cosmetics Blush Palette. I use it on the eyes. I use Rivera Red. I'm sorry, Riviera Red is what I use, which is this color right here.
Your dad does rapping and DJing, right?
Yeah.
I also use from Vera Moore Cosmetics eyeshadow palette.
Awesome, this looks.
We have the,
oh my god. This is
the Sunrise and Aqua, as well as the 24 karat. So I have the Sunrise, Aqua, and a little bit of the 24 karat to bring out the corners of the eyelid.
We only got the brown, red. Not this Sunrise, but that's
kind of
I have some money. Yeah,
those
you can
hold up. Back up.
Let me see it before you do that. Let me see how it looks.
All the connections, correct?
Oh, you look okay. You look good.
Hold on. Babe.
You told me to come on. Now you're going to say hold on.
Go.
Okay, so here we have the end results using Vera Moore Cosmetics. You all can find her products on VeraMoreCosmetics.com, as well as you can find her on Instagram at Vera Moore Cos. That's VeraMoreCos. Oh, and one more touch up. We cannot forget the lips. I want to do this over another time.
These two are empty.
So you don't really want this one? All right.
This is one of her lipsticks called Yes. Y-E-S. I mean, sorry, Y-E-S. It's so beautiful.
Kind of
like
the library classes,
okay?
You can play it. You've got to keep the library.
No.
I can give you the knife, though. The knife will let you know.
And this is one of her hint of mints called Golden Persimmon.
Oh yeah, and pink.
Like golden persimmon. Some shit like that.
Some of the stuff I gotta keep in the library. That's my favorite color.
Kind of move around a little bit. Let me see.
I'm giving you these to take home. I'm just gonna put them in here because I don't get them.
To the side? Okay, so.
Or even you can make like little, almost like a little desert island that's in the middle of the ocean.
Megan, do you have a bag for the shoes?
Yes, I do.